The channel you want to listen to, Dover Community Radio.
This is Terry Cleave here reporting for Dover Community Radio. It's Saturday the 2nd of July. We're at the Dover Regatta and we're at the Dover Steamship Company stand. Here with me I have...
Andy McLean.
Hello Andy, nice to talk to you today. Could you tell us a little bit about the TSS Dover?
Yes, in fact... TSS Dover came into service in 1965, and at that time she was the flagship of the British Railways car ferry fleet, and she was engaged on the Dover to Boulogne route. She was the very last steam turbine powered car ferry to be built for British Railways, and she is a bit of an iconic vessel because she is the last steam turbine powered car ferry existing in the world. All the rest have been scrapped. So what we're trying to do at the Dover Steamship Company is to rescue her from the scrapyard where she sits at the moment in Middlesbrough. And our project over the next 9 to 10 years is to completely restore her to seagoing capability. And our ambition is that she should be based in Dover. She's called Dover. Dover was her home port originally, and you know, we see this as the natural home for the ship.
So when was the actual project launched?
It was launched last year. We had tried 3 or 4 years ago to do the same thing, but unfortunately things fell through because the people who owned her at the time were in the process of going bankrupt and there was nobody to actually negotiate with. And it's only recently that it's come to light that technically nobody owns her. She's owned by the Crown, and for the princely sum of £1 she's yours, or she could be anybody's. The problem is, of course, once you pay that pound you then take on all the responsibility for the vessel, and that includes berthing fees, and at the moment unfortunately she has sunk at her moorings, because what we think has happened is the glands and the prop shafts have gone and the seawater has got in through the prop shafts, and gradually the vessel has sunk. She's only sunk up to the about halfway up the car deck, so at high tide on the River Tees, which is where she is, the sea comes up to about halfway up the car deck. It's not difficult to refloat, expensive to refloat, but not difficult. But we have been informed that the Ministry of Defence are quite interested in using her as an exercise for their employees to actually refloat her for us. So it could well be that we can get that done for free. Then she has to be dry docked. The hull has to be made good. The actual structure of the hull is sound. She was surveyed not too long ago, and the survey showed that the thickness of the steel plates in the hull is good. So there's no great problem there. She's got to be made seaworthy. We need to restore her engine. She was steam turbine. The steam part of her, the boiler, boilers rather, can be re-engineered on site, actually in the ship, but the turbines, very very complicated equipment, we'll have to take them out of the ship, and they'll have to be taken back to Parsons in Newcastle, which is where they were built, and they'll have to have a complete refurbish. But our hope is that Parsons may take this on as an apprentice project, in which case the costs once again could be minimized. So although we've got an overall budget of about 14-15 million to bring her back to seagoing capability, it could be quite a lot less than that. Once we've got the hull in order, our ambition is to get her towed back to Dover, and for all of the work from then on for her restoration to be done here. And this would involve a lot of job training, a lot of work experience, a lot of job creation, and you know, we see it as being quite a focal point to sort of regenerate Dover.
Could you please describe the ship for our listeners?
Yeah, she was built, she's a purpose-built car ferry. She carried 205 cars, and she originally had a capacity for 750 passengers, but that was uprated to 1,000 later on in her career when she was taken to Norway, or Denmark, sorry, it was Denmark, and she was converted to a complete drive-through ferry, because originally she only had a stern door, but they converted her to a drive-through ferry and renamed her Earl Seaward. So quite a lot of people in Dover area probably know her as Earl Seaward and not as Dover. That's when they uprated the passenger capacity to 1,000. Still had only a capacity for 205 cars, or a mixture of commercial vehicles, coaches and cars. She has got already on board bars and restaurants. Obviously all of these need to be restored, but the ambition is to restore her to seagoing capability, to possibly have a museum of the cross-channel trade on her, to use her for training of deck officers and ratings, also perhaps as a sea cadet base. There are all sorts of projects that she could be used for.
So I see you're actually down here at the regatta today. How's promotion of the project been going?
It's gone very well. We've recruited quite a few new members for the steamship company today. A lot of old ferry hands have stopped by to see us. Some of them have been engineers, some of them deck officers, some of them ratings, and everyone is extremely interested in the project. It's obviously a big project. It's not small beer by any manner, but it is achievable, and that's the main thing. As long as we can see it through, we're certain it can be achieved. We're promised that once she becomes a heritage vessel, which will be another 2 years, because ships have to be a certain age to become heritage vessels, that we can apply for funds, and quite substantial funds, from the Heritage Lottery Fund. So that will help us a lot. Just to put it in perspective, we're talking about 15 million. They've just spent 40 million to bring the Cutty Sark back up to standard. So the money is around.
So how can people actually find out more or donate to the project?
Right, well, we'd very much like them to. We do have open meetings every couple of months, which we publicise in the local papers, and we'll obviously try and publicise it with you guys as well. We have a website, which is www.tssdover.co.uk, and if people log on to that, or if you just go into Google and put in TSS Dover, TSS stands for Turbine Steamship, by the way. If you just put that in Google, it'll take you through to our site, and latest news is published on there. All of the statistics about the vessel are there, and we just really need to generate interest in the local area to get this project moving.
And finally, Andy, why should people in the Dover area actually be interested in the project? Why should they get involved?
It depends on what your view of history is, really. A lot of people take the view that history is extremely important. It's something there to mould our attitude to today and also to tomorrow. We should learn from history. The Dover vessel is iconic. She's the very last of the steam turbine ships. And she represents British shipbuilding industry at its peak. And she represents us oldsters, I guess, would say was the heyday of cross-channel traffic, which we believe was the 1960s and early 70s.
Thanks very much, Andy. That's great. I wish you all the best with the project.
Thank you very much indeed. Well, we hope to see you again.
The channel you want to listen to, Dover Community Radio.